Hey, Jim Flavin here, also known as Plain to Grow Jim. I appreciate that you're checking out my YouTube channel, Plain to Grow Jim. I'd also appreciate it if you check out my website, and that's plaintogrowsystems.com. Hey, Plain to Grow Jim, I'm going to show you a tool that you might not know about that can help you grow better vegetables and fruits. Now this tool is called a handheld refractometer, and this will help you measure the amount of sugar in your fruit. You're saying, why would I need to know how much sugar is in the fruit? Well, that is a big part of your plant. Sugars are very important to your plant and to your fruits. It's what determines the flavor and the sweetness of your fruit. Now this is what a typical handheld refractometer looks like. They all look pretty much the same. They're slightly different in style and construction, but they're all pretty much the same. You can see it's got a little window there. I'm going to flip this. It flops open. You have a glass plate there. It's kind of hard to see down inside there. That clear plastic cover does a couple things. It lets the light in through your sample, and it helps squish down the fluid to make a very thin film on that glass that I just showed you. It's a very well polished glass. Now this particular model here I got from a company off of eBay, and I paid around $35 for this one. It's made out of aluminum. It's very heavy duty. This is a temperature control version of it. This will give you automatic temperature control. These range in price anywhere from around $30 up to $100+, so you have to shop around. They're all pretty much the same. It looks like they all pretty much come from the same manufacturer, so price around. I was very pleased with this and very pleased with the company. Now this is looking inside the scale. You can see it goes from 0 to 30 on this one. This is actually looking through the refractometer. You can get these in different scales. The 0 to 30% is good for fruits and vegetables. There are other refractometers designed for brewers and sugar manufacturers and that sort of thing. For our purposes, for checking your fruits and vegetables, the 0 to 30% is fine. You can see this kit comes with a nice little plastic box. It's lined with foam. Protect it. These are pretty tough. You don't want to be dropping them or doing anything like that. Comes with a pipette and a screwdriver, and the screwdriver is to adjust the unit so you can calibrate it. This eyepiece screws in and out. You can use it to adjust the focus on the inside. Comes with a little one-page operation manual. It explains it to some extent, but you're going to have to get on the internet and do some studying on percent Brix and or degrees Brix. You can hear it both ways. These are some Rio Grande Roma style tomatoes that I grew from seed out of my latest HydroSock jug system, the off the grid combat HydroSock jug that I did a video on recently on my YouTube channel. Now this is just a computer screenshot to show you that you can find charts on degrees Brix, and again, that's the amount of sugar that's in your plants and your vegetables and your fruits on this chart, and all are pretty similar. They're all pretty close. This shows that tomatoes should show somewhere in the range of 8 to 12% for a good to excellent tomato. Anything below that's not very good. So we're going to find out how well we did with this. Just to give you a quick and dirty explanation of how a refractometer works, basically it's got, you can see it's got an angle to it. That's because it has a prism inside there. It has a glass prism, and what that does is it bends the light like any prism does, you know, how it'll break your white light into all the different colors, the wavelengths. And so what this does, what the prism does is, I don't know the exact science of it with this particular, with the refractometer, but what it does is when you put your sample on there, when the light goes through the fluid, and it's going to be an aqueous solution, it's going to be water and sugar, it bends the light and then comes out on that scale to show you percent by weight. So if this scale showed, say, 10%, that would be 10% of the weight of that sample in sugar. And that would be a pretty good number for just about anything. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut a piece of it off, about a quarter of it, and I'm going to mush it in my mortar and pestle that you see in the background. And then we'll suck it up with a eyedropper and test it. Now I've completely crushed that up and made a paste out of it, and I'm going to use a glass eyedropper instead of that plastic pipette, because those things are kind of hard to clean. So I'm going to take a bit of the juice out of there and make sure you don't get seeds and stuff. There we go, that's probably enough. We'll put that on there. I got one seed, and we'll just push that off the side. Alright, I'll put that shield down, press it down. Well, after reviewing the video of the Brix test, it looks like I came out closer to a 9.5 to 10 on the percent scale on the Brix, which is more in line with that Roma tomato that I grew. That was a Rio Grande, which I've never grown before in my system, so that was new to me. But Roma tomatoes in general, they're a lot firmer, less juicy, more for sauces and things like that. The bigger slicing tomatoes, the big round, very red slicing tomatoes tend to come out a lot higher in the sugar. But a 9.5 to 10 on most scales, that puts it in the good to excellent range. So I'm pretty pleased. For a first time on that from seed, I can't complain. You can see I've got a couple tools here. I've got the refractometer, like we talked about. And it's not the end-all tool that some people think that it is. You've got some people that eat, live, and breathe by the refractometer with their vegetables and say that's the only way to check for true nutrition in a vegetable and a fruit. I'm not sure that's the case, but it is a very useful tool. It does give you a good idea at the end of your growing cycle what choices you made on the nutrients and the temperature and pH and everything else, and it does give you a good end result, because that is the basic food of the plant. The sucrose that's in the plant, that is how the plant grows. That's how it makes chlorophyll. That's basically what it eats. And so that is a good indication of the quality of your plant. And from what I can see, most tables on fruits and vegetables, if you're above a 6, you're doing pretty good. Some store-bought stuff, some of it shows like 3 to 4, maybe touches 5. Homegrown stuff usually goes 6 and above. And so I'm real pleased. So this is a good, useful tool. And like I said, if you shop around, you can get them from around 30, all the way up to, I've seen the same thing in some places for up to over $100. So definitely have to shop around. But this is rugged. It's good. It's good little units. Well made. I'm very pleased with it. Very easy to use. Now, in the meantime, when you're during growing your plants, a good thing to have is at least a pH meter, an electronic pH meter. Now, this particular meter from Milwaukee, and I've done a blog on this, so you can go to my blog and find out more about how meters work, how the multimeters work, and what they test. This one has pH, it has parts per million, it has electrical conductivity, and it has total dissolved solids. And so that gives me a good idea of what I'm doing with my plants. pH, I'm constantly checking pH, and it's very important to me. It's one of the most important things in your plant. And so these are very useful tools. You don't have to go out and spend a couple $100 on that meter. You can get a little inexpensive electronic pH meter, or you can even buy the test strips and litmus paper, whatever you want to use. Just check it all the time. But this gives you kind of an ongoing end result between the two.